This factory in Germany has made engines for some of the most popular cars in the world for over five decades.
Ever wish you owned a Volkswagen?
But more recently, some of those cars have lost their shine.
VW owners coming to grips with the realization that their diesel cars can emit from 10 to 40 times more pollutants.
We all know that we have let down customers.
What's more, global sales of internal combustion engines are predicted to drop by over 50% by 2035. The hot new market? Electric vehicles. So to try and capture that market, VW is transforming this engine factory into its new EV battery facility, the first of six that it plans to build in Europe, at a cost of about $15 billion, according to analysts.
What you see behind has nothing to do with combustion engines, and that shows the size of this transformation.
That means going from making combustion engines that have more than 2,000 moving parts to high-tech electric motors that only have about 20. And changing its workforce to do that.
Traditional automakers, if they want to be in this market in 2035, they need to develop just as much as the startups need to develop.
The EV market is currently dominated by Tesla and faces disruption from a bunch of new startups.
They have nothing to lose. They start from scratch. We have a lot to lose.
So could this factory be a blueprint for traditional automakers to survive the EV revolution? While VW says that its battery factory in Salzgitter won't be online for another 2 years or so, Tesla already has several gigafactories in operation and completed its Shanghai facility in under a year. It also says it's nearing completion of a huge plant here in Germany.
We've decided to put Tesla Gigafactory Europe in the Berlin area.
Other well-funded startups like Lucid and Rivian have set up brand new factories to start EV production this year. So legacy automakers like GM, Ford and VW have all announced they're investing billions into EV production to defend their market share, with VW committing to $43 billion in 5 years.
When you look at what the startups are doing, they don't have to transition. You don't have to change a legacy footprint. So traditional automakers don't have the luxury of sitting back and saying, we'll wait and see how it goes.
We are responsible for the people and for our customers, and we have to transform.
So how is VW investing that money in Salzgitter? Well, some of those decisions are made by this engineer, Frank Blohm.
We are building a small-scale cells right now, and now we are building up the first mass production plant.
VW has converted part of its existing factory into labs and a pilot line to test and refine the science behind its batteries. It plans to build a brand new facility right next to it, which could produce batteries for over 600,000 vehicles a year, and is expected to cost around $2.5 billion, according to analysts. Although it says it hasn't finalised the designs for its new facility yet, the factory is expected to be similar to this one in Sweden. It's owned by battery supplier Northvolt, and VW is a major investor in the company. Thomas Schmoll is CEO of VW's component division.
The bottleneck will be how fast you can establish, increase and ramp up your battery business.
Within its labs, VW is trying to figure out what kind of batteries its electric vehicles will need in the future. It's testing battery recycling technology. And to get ahead of the competition, it's experimenting with next generation solid state batteries, which don't contain liquid lithium and promise far faster charging and greater mileage.
Fast charge is a big, big topic for us. We are working on that with the big workforce.
The transition will affect everyone in this plant. The company will need fewer mechanical engineers and will need new people with totally different skills, like electrochemists or developers, as EVs need so much software that VW is set to become one of the largest tech companies in Europe.
To find the right people is a challenge. It's a new industry, everybody wants electrochemistry people.
I think the big outstanding question is we know that it will take fewer employees to build a battery cell pack. So therefore, how do you figure that out? Where do you transition people to?
As the battery plant grows, over time, part of the staff will be retrained, while some legacy jobs are expected to go away. At the end of this transition, it's unclear whether the overall number of workers on this site will go down. Globally, VW has already made some cuts. In 2019, the company announced that it was cutting some 7,000 jobs over 5 years, and since 2016, it has eliminated at least 23,000 positions by offering early retirement and not replacing workers.
We always have this issue, maybe it's destroying business. No, it's not right. You can, if you do it right, you can create jobs. We will have 1,500, 1,600 employees in the new cell business, what we are doing here, and that's not the end. because this is only the first portion, the first part of the cell plant.
The stakes are particularly high for VW, as it's trying to change its image as a polluter, while also meeting new environmental regulations around the world. After the emissions scandal in 2015, VW pleaded guilty to installing a device on its vehicles to cheat US emissions tests.
It is not only our cars we have to fix. We know we have to repair our credibility too.
Today, as VW bets big on electric, its US sales are much lower than they were in 2012.
I think it does dovetail with needing to prove that they're clean and having that kind of hanging over their heads. Because it does, the news doesn't stop on that. It does still pop up. So the issue isn't completely dead.
So just like this factory, the decades-old company has to reinvent itself to keep up with technology and beat competitors old and new.